All right, welcome to our next stop on the tour. This is known as the City of Manchester. The City of Manchester was a very unique little streetcar built in 1897. It was built by the Briggs Carriage Company of Amesbury, Massachusetts. Now, you just heard the word carriage company. Well, in the 1890s, as electric railways were growing in leaps and bounds, and there were companies popping up all over America to construct streetcars, and nobody was buying carriages because people could ride streetcars now. They were faster, they'd go more places. So a lot of carriage companies tried to change their gears and turn their factories into making streetcars. They did this for just a little bit of time, and then they got bought out by a larger railway company that built streetcars. So that's what happened. If you were small, you still got kind of sucked up by a bigger company anyway. But they built this magnificent car for Manchester, but it was not a car for anybody to ride on. This was a private limo car. The gentleman who owned the Manchester Street Railway, this was his pride and joy to ride around the system on. You could rent this car out for $5 a day, and he would provide you with a young gentleman to serve you hard booze. There was 4 liquor cabinets in this car, and you could have your little party on this car. Now, the main purpose of this parlor car for a mill town like Manchester, New Hampshire, was, let's say you owned a shoe company. Maybe you owned a shirt company, and you were looking at several New England mills to open up your company, and you come to Manchester. This guy would wine and dine you and try to tell you that Manchester is the best place for you to have your business, because the more people that were riding streetcars in Manchester meant more money for this guy. So it was a crucial advertising car. Now, when this car was retired in 1929, you won't believe it, this became a children's playhouse in somebody's backyard. Children played in this streetcar in their backyard until we acquired it in the early 1950s. And this was the first streetcar to be restored at the Seashore Trolley Museum when we opened up our doors in 1952. We've been here since 1939, but we were not open to the public until 1952. Now, the last thing I want to mention, changing gears. The company in Amesbury changed gears to make streetcars. Well, this happened again at the end of the streetcar era. There's a company in High Point, North Carolina that built those famous streetcar named Desires. We do own one of those cars. It runs today in Lowell, Massachusetts, along with the National Park Service in Lowell. So we do have a New Orleans car, but it's in Lowell, built by Pearly Thomas. Pearly Thomas. Today, there is a company that makes buses, school buses, called Thomas Built. That's the same company. So if you rode a school bus called Thomas Built Bus, you're riding something that built those New Orleans guys.